My name is Faris Davison, and I'm a community reporter in Dangamvura, Mutare, Zimbabwe. Dangamvura is a population of around 100,000 people whose right to water is not being fulfilled by the city of Mutare. As a woman, I feel that the non-fulfillment of this important social and economic right by the city of Mutare remain a cause for concern. Some of the most affected areas are Gimboki, Destiny, and Area 3, with around 30,000 households. There is virtually no water provided by the local authority in these areas I've just mentioned. There are three boreholes that service the Gimboki area and four communal taps that service Destiny area. Residents depend on unprotected shallow wells for water. Women and girls wake up very early in the morning to go and fetch water. They spend night vigils waiting for water at various shallow wells dotted in the area. At these water points, women and girls are abused. Some are even molested. Some unscrupulous men claim that the shallow wells belong to them, so women are forced to pay in cash or in kind. Physical fights are the order of the day, where women suffer various forms of indignity. They also walk long distances of around 5 to 10 kilometers to look for this precious commodity in areas like Lora communal area in search of safer sources of water. Recently, in Area 3 section of Dangamvura, a toddler was killed after being left under the care of an aunt who is mentally challenged while the mother had gone to fetch water at a communal water point. Also, in Section N of Dangamvura, another toddler drowned in a dish of water which was stored in the house. Through engagement efforts of WILSA, UMRAT, TIZ and ZIMCOD, Mutare City Council is now constructing a water pipeline to augment the water situation in Dangamvura. We really appreciate this initiative by the local authority and the partners for their effort to bring clean and potable water to residents, which will liberate women and reduce social inequalities by redeploying them to productive economic activities. I encourage WILSA and the other partners involved to continue engaging with the city of Mutare so that the water project is completed soon. I thank